नमस्ते, ग्रेस राउत इंग्लिश टीचर। माय डियर स्टूडेंट्स, स्टडी आई डिस्कस्ड ओवर द बेसिक कंसेप्ट ऑफ नरेशन एंड जनरल वाज गोइंग ऑन अंडर जनरल we have completed up to personal change. Now, in today's class, my focus will be on other basic changes of under generals. Tense change, adverbial change, vocative case or parenthesis change. My dear students, change of tense, let's see here, word, we may call it tense change also. Let's see the examples, what happens under tense change, how does tense change take place? I'll start from here, sir. He says to me, I am playing football. See here. What is its indirect speech? He says to has been changed into tells here. In place of inverted commas, I have used that. That is used. She is first person. It changes according to subject. First person, subjective case. Subjective case. Case matched. We'll copy the same over here. But my focus is on here. On tense. Will the tense be changed here? No. Will not change the tense over here. Huh? His aim will be is here because subject is he now. But we are not going to change the tense over here. So answer is he is playing football. Change. Tense has not been changed over here. Do you know the reason? Why? Why tense hasn't been changed here? Just think and come to yours. Let's see your example. Ram will say to her, will say. Will say becomes will tell. Will say to becomes will tell because tell doesn't take two preposition. That in place of adverbial commas that we use. I first person is changing according to subject. What's the pronoun for Ram? He. So he is here. Again, no change in tense. My focus is over there. There is no change in tense. My dear students, now let me know what can you say by studying these two examples there? What is in conclusion? What can you say in conclusion there? In conclusion, we must say if reporting clause, this word is reporting clause, and this is reporting verb. If reporting clause is in present tense or future tense, then there is no change in the tense of reported clause. Tense change doesn't take place under two conditions. The voting clause is to be in simple present tense or simple future tense. I will show you one more example here. He says to me, comma, inverted comma, I have called you. See here. What is this reporting verb change into? See here on the chart too. Says to is changed into tells. So I write here tells. Tells. Observe the listener, me, that. When you want these inverted commas and this comma, must use that here. Because this is an assertive sentence. I'll come over there later on. That. First person according to subject. See, subjective case, subjective case. Case matched. We'll copy the same here. He. I will not change the tense here. Because this reporting clause, reporting verb is in simple present. But he takes has. We cannot use have with he. He has called. Second person according to object. Objective case, objective case. Case matched. So write me here again. But my dear students, let's see other examples over here. He said, I am playing. See, is there an object in the reporting clause? No. If there is no object in the reporting clause, we will copy the same reporting verb here. We will change into tell, tells or told. It remains same. Because there is no object. That, because it's an assertive sentence. First person, according to subject, he. See here, am playing. Which tense is this? Present continuous. Am is a plus before. It has been changed into was playing. Past continuous. Tense has been changed here. So, why? Why has this present continuous tense become past continuous? What's the procedure there? What's the formula there? Why? I'll tell you about these two. Before that, let's see the next example again here. Ram said to me, see here, it is simple past. Said to becomes told here. Ram told me that. See, third person, no change. See, doesn't like playing tennis. Simple present tense. It has become, you don't like playing tennis. Simple past tense. So, why? What has happened here? Yes. This present continuous has become past continuous. The simple present tense has become simple past because of corresponding change. Now, must know the concept of corresponding past tense. What is corresponding past tense? Literally, corresponding means equivalent. Similar past. Similar past. I mean, if we have simple present tense in direct narration, it should be changed into simple past in indirect narration. This is called corresponding past. Similar past. Equivalent past. Present continuous into past continuous. Present perfect change into past perfect. Present perfect continuous, past perfect continuous. Simple past, past perfect. Past continuous, past perfect continuous. Past perfect, no change. Past perfect continuous, again no change. Shall becomes should in indirect speech. Will becomes would. May into might. Can into could. Has to have to into had to. Had to into her had to. Ism or into was where. Has have into had. Would, should, could, might. Then again, present. This is the corresponding past. This is how you will change the tense. This tense chart, this corresponding change of tense chart is quite fundamental, quite essential, very basic, very backbone of narration. If you don't know this, it will be difficult for you. So, try to remember this too, learn this too. Again, but besides these all I have written here, must. What is this must change into? What is this must change into? I will write you here. Must. Must used in direct direction. May have four purposes there. Four purposes. I will write here first example. He said, comma inverted comma, I, not like I here, we must respect our elders. See here. What does this must represent here? What does it show here? It shows duty. I write here duty. Second, he said to me, okay, I must call a doctor. I must call a doctor. What does this must show here? Present necessity. Present necessity. Again, right, he said, I must come tomorrow. I must come tomorrow. What does must denote here? Future necessity. Future necessity. And last, he said, I mustn't smoke. Yes, it shows prohibition. 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 Nishet. So, how do you change this? Let's change here. He. No object, remains same. Said that. See here. Again, we. First person, according to subject. According to subject. It is plural. What is the plural of he? They. So, should I write they here? I don't suppose that. It's you again. Used in broad sense here. We all, throughout the world, people of throughout the world must respect our values there. So this is used in broad sense. So, same. Now, what is to be understood, my dear students? If must shows duty, then remains same. It's not changed. Same. I write as same. So, must same. Respect our elders. Let's see. Next one. He said to becomes told me that I, first person, according to subject, what should be a he? And what does it show here? Present necessity. Immediately I have to call a doctor. If must shows present necessity, it becomes had to. Had to in indirect speech. So what's the answer here? He had to call a doctor. Yes. It's come over here. What? So he, no object, same. He said that I, he, future necessity. Bholi maunu parcha. Future necessity. If must shows future necessity, it becomes would have to plus P1. I mean, what's the answer here? He would have to come and tomorrow becomes the next day. Yes. The last one here. He said, I mustn't smoke. Spelling is wrong here. I mustn't smoke. Mustn't smoke. It shows prohibition. It says. So by the way, first he knows that same. Said that I, according to subject, he. It must show prohibition, then it changes into was or were plus. Not to plus B1. So with he what? Was or when? Was. So he was not to smoke. Yes. This is how we say it first into indirect speech. The same story too I told you. I might have told you. English. No, it's a crazy language. The rules are not used unanimously. So I will talk over the exceptional cases of change too. But before that, I have some examples here. Let's see over here. Oh, sorry. So let's see some examples over here again. She said to me, I want to give you my pen. Said to, told me that is used over here. First person, change the point to subject, see. Now see here, want, I want to give. What tense is this? Simple present tense. This is changed into simple past tense. She wanted. What is the past of what? Wanted. To give. You second person going to object. Objective case. Objective case. Matched. Me. My first person according to subject. See. What? Which good cases this mind. Possessive one. What is the possessive one of mine? Her. Her. Next example. He said to me, I have no time for you. Said to becomes told. Me, that, collective. I becomes he, according to the speaker. Speaker is he here. He. It's sad. Simple past becomes past perfect. Had had. What's the answer? Had has. He had had. No time for you. Second person again. According to object. What's the object here? Me. Objective place. Objective place. Guess best. Me. See over here. Sita said to Ram, you should, could, might help her. Here too, said to becomes told. Sita told Ram that you second person going to object. What's the object here? Ram. What's the pronoun for Ram? He. So he. And we will not change these verbs. Auxiliary verbs. Should, could, would, might, because they are not changed. They remain unchanged in indirect speech. So answer is he should, could, would, might help. And her is her, her third person must change there. So let's see some exceptional cases now which do not follow change of tense, the code of change of tense. Change of tense ko norms na manne ke examples of hum yahan se exceptional cases there. Okay, let's see some exceptional cases. Under that, let's see the example first. My teacher said, comma, inverted comma, the earth moves round the sun. See here. What's the answer here? My teacher said remains same because no object. Said that because this is an assorted sentence. The earth same tense is used here. The earth moves around the sun. So no change in the tense here. Tense is not changed. So what can we say in common? Even reporting her is in simple past. Even reporting clause is in simple past. We will not change the tense of universal truth. Or eternal truth here. This is universal truth. Eternal truth. So no change in the tense of eternal truth. Universal truth. This is what is said here. Universal truth. Truths of science, science, proverbs, general truths. When we have this in the reported clause, any proverb? Any proverb, let's see. He said, comma, inverted comma. Old is good. Old is good. So this is the proverb. Again, there will be no change in the tense. He said that old is good. So, this is the first exceptional case here. Now, I'll talk about the second one here. Second one, what's it to be here? Simple present tense, future time. Let's see the example here. He said, comma, but a comma, my brother lives for Kathmandu tomorrow. See here. Is there object? No. Same. He said that my brother, according to subject, according to speaker, his brother. See, this simple present tense, according to the rule of tense change, is to be changed in simple past. There should be left, but it doesn't follow that. If you write left, it becomes wrong. Why? Though this simple present tense shows future time. So simple present tense showing future time becomes would plus be one. Would live for Kathmandu the next day. Let's see the next example. What's here over here? Present continuous tense showing future time. Let's see again here. She said to me, comma, but a comma, I am coming tomorrow again. I am coming tomorrow. So first this change into C said to becomes toward me that I according to subject C see here. This is present continuous tense. And it's to be changed into past continuous. According to the rule of corresponding past, it should be past continuous. But if we change it into past continuous, strong way. Because we have future time running here. Though it is present continuous tense showing future time, the present continuous tense showing future time becomes would be plus before. Would be plus before. What answer then? C would be coming the next day. Similarly, next exceptional case here. Simple past, past continuous tense in a verb process of time. Let's see what is this. Let me give you an example here again. He said to her, when I was sleeping, my friend called me. See here. What is this change into again? He told her that, see here, past continuous tense and simple past tense are used together here. Past continuous tense and simple past tense used together and so time here. They are adverb clauses of time. They are used as adverb clauses of time here. This so time. If two clauses, simple past and past continuous tense, used as adverb clauses of time, they are not changed into indirect speech. So what is the answer here? when I becomes he, when he, no change in tense, when he was sleeping, my becomes first person to your subject, his friend called him. Again, first person according to subject, him. See here. So, first simple to the now. Past continuous tense and simple past tense used at a verb process of time. Not changed into indirect speech. The tense remains unchanged there. Person change take place, but no change in the tense. No change in the tense there. Similarly, we have the next one. The last except for case one. Verbs used in clauses expressing improbable or impossible condition. Let's see. Hari said, comma, but a comma, if I were a bird, I would fly in the sky. Fly in the sky. So, no object, same. He said that we write this if as it is here. First person according to subject, first subject here, Hari. So, write he here. And no change in tense here. Because this is hypothetical case. His verbs were and would fly, they are used as. Used to show impossible condition, improbable condition here. Is it possible for a person to be a bird? Impossible. So if verbs show impossible condition, we will not change the tense. So what's the answer here? If he were a bird, he. Tense person change will take place. He would fly, yes, in the sky. This is how change of tense completes. Now we'll talk on the next changes, next change, adverbial change. So I will drop this now and let's see here one example again of adverbial change here. Examples. She said, I am very happy to be here this morning. My focus is now on adverbs. Less on person, less on tense, less on reporting her, but more on adverbs. She said here, this. So here, she said, said remains same because there is no object. That is used. I, first person according to subject. My dear students. C should be here. C. She said C. And simple present. M becomes simple past. She was very happy to be here. It's a verb. So it's time. Here becomes there. This shows time. This becomes that. So these two adverbs have been changed here. Here has been changed into there, and this has been changed into that. Here the place is adverbial. This is the time adverbial, and they have been changed into there and that. Similarly, I saw her the day before yesterday. She said. See, reporting clause is at last here. You can keep that body clause at first. Though it comes at last, we can keep it at first. It's possible. She said that she here. Simple past tense, this becomes past perfect. Past perfect. Saw has become had seen. Had seen. Heard. Her third person, no change. She, the day before yesterday. The day before yesterday is changed into 2 days before. This is a verbal change, time verbal change. Let's see one more example here. Hari said they completed their study a year ago. Hari said remains same because there is no object. That their third person, no change. Completed simple past, this has been changed into past perfect. Had completed their third person, no change, study a year. Avo has been changed into before here. So, what by studying these three examples, by analyzing these three examples, what can be said in conclusion? The conclusion is that verbs which show nearer time or place, listen to me carefully, my dear students, that verbs which show nearer time are changed into the adverbials which show distance. नजिक को बुझाने टाइम एडवर्बियल्स र प्लेस एडवर्बियल्स लाई टाढा को बुझाने टाइम एडवर्बियल्स र प्लेस एडवर्बियल्स चेंज गर्नु पर्छ. दिस इज व्हाट आई मीन टू से. सो फ्रॉम दीज एग्जांपल्स वी कैन राइट दिस सोर्स. दिस विल हेल्प यू इन पर्सन चेंज देयर सही चेंज ऑफ एडवर्बियल्स. दिस विल हेल्प टू चेंज एडवर्ब्स. दिस हैज बिकम्स दैट. दिस बिकम्स दोस. Here, there, thus, so, now, then, hence, thence, today, that day, tonight, that night, next, the following, the last, previous, ago, before, tomorrow, the next day, the following day, the day after tomorrow, in 2 days time, yesterday, the day before, the previous day, the day yesterday into 2 days before. So this is all about your adverbial change. Now one more last small topic is left here, my dear students. Change of vocative case or parenthesis. What do you mean by vocative case and parenthesis? Let's see one example here. Hari said, comma and butter comma, well, Ram, you can enjoy the party. See here. Here is Ram. Addressed in this reported clause? Ram. Who is addressed in the reported clause? Ram. So Ram is vocative. The persons who are addressed in the reported clause are in vocative. And remember, my dear students, vocative case becomes the object of reporting clause in indirect speech. See here. Hari told Ram. This Ram has come here, has become an object here. If we have vocative case, that becomes the object of reporting clause in indirect speech here. Whereas, what is this well? Well is parenthesis. What do we have parenthesis here? Parenthesis means here the word or group of words which simply come to introduce the sentence. They don't have their own existence. They simply come to introduce the sentence. The words which come in such a way, the words which are in such a role, are termed as parenthesis, comment clause. And such parenthesis is left out. See here, well has been omitted here. It's not kept here. Well has been omitted. Well has been omitted here. Let's see an example here. He said, I want to meet you, Mohan. So, what is this Mohan now? Vocative case. Who is addressed in this reported clause? Who is addressed? First line, Sambodhan Garyeko cha, Mohan. So, Mohan is vocative case. And vocative case becomes object in the reporting clause. So, what answer then? He told Mohan. So whenever, although there is no object, but we are keeping this as an object here. So we must change this set into told here. He told Mohan that first person equal subject, he, simple present into simple past, wanted to meet. And you are going to object. Mohan here. Mohan has become object now. You are going to Mohan, him here. See, last one here. He said, okay, she can do this. What is this okay? Parenthesis. Again, I would like to say you, parenthesis does not have its one value, one existence. It comes only to introduce the sentence. See, it has come to introduce this sentence. This sentence. So it is to be omitted. It's not kept in that speech. What's like the oh, well, very well, okay, you know, as you know, to tell you frankly. These words can be used as parentheses and such words are omitted. So, this is all about today's class. And before to end my class, I would like to give you some exercises as homework. You must do this homework. Tomorrow, I will dictate the answers from here. Till you start.